Just give this video a thumbs up by liking, and if you haven't subscribed to my channel, just do that right now, because I'm going to upload more tutorial videos and more videos. So make sure you stay tuned to my channel, because you can learn a lot from this generator. So first, we are going to start with the network IC. I will show you the network IC on this PCB, then tell you how I get to know that this is the network IC and this IC is this one. So right here on this PCB, here is the network IC. This IC right here is the network IC. So how did I know that this is the network IC? What I want you to understand that when you hold any PCB right in front of you, you will have this section. You will see that they have separated all the sections with a silver shield that is always covering the bigger ICs on the PCB. So if you look here, you will see that the sections are really clear. So what you need to know right here on this PCB, that here is the network section. And the reason why I noticed that this is the network section is because if you check here on this section, you won't see any power component. What I mean by a power component, you won't see any bigger capacitor. You won't see any bigger diode. You won't see any bigger coil right here. You understand what I'm saying, right? So instead, you will see things like blue ridge resistors, which we have filter resistors in them, and we have package resistors. If I want to talk about package resistors right here, you will get confused, because the package resistors on this PCB are different. The package resistors on this PCB are different. You see this ICs right here. These are combination of package resistors, but I'm going to show you the package resistors on a different PCB in this video. So make sure you stay tuned. So the reason why I knew that this is the network IC is because we have filter resistors right here. We have these little resistors right here. And if you check right here, you will see that this is the network crystal. If you check right here, you will see that this is the network crystal. So any mobile PCB, let me show you another PCB right here so that you will understand how it's been identified very easily. If I put this PCB right here, I think you will show me the network IC already. For this PCB, here is the network IC. And if you check around, you will see the package resistors, which are PGA, SMD, which are surface mounted in one IC. You understand? Then you will have the network crystal. Any network IC has a network crystal for signal amplification. I hope you do understand well. So let's concentrate on the PCB that we were working on. So now this is the network IC. Then you are asking, what about these other ICs right here? They have the little filter resistors around them. Here, this is the 3G and 4G signal amplifier IC. And this one right here is the RF IC, which is the 2G signal amplifier IC. And this one right here is still RF IC, which combines all the 2G, 3G and 4G signal amplification. So how you can identify, like, for example, let me just give you an example. If your phone is having low connection, like less network signal, then what you have to check, you are going to check the first thing, you are going to check the IC, you are going to follow the line, the antenna line. When you follow it and it gets to any IC first, you need to know that that is the signal amplifier IC. This IC right here amplifies the 2G, 3G and the 4G network. This IC right here amplifies the signal that is coming out from this RF IC right here, and the one that is coming out from the main network IC right here. And still, if you are having less network signal, it can still be the crystal problem, because this crystal right here takes signal from this network IC and amplifies the signal, then send it back to the network IC before the network IC distribute the signal to the network signal amplifier. You understand what I'm saying, which is this. So now you know about the network section and you know how to identify the network section. And what I'm going to show you next is the Wi-Fi IC. But before we go on, I want you to understand that Wi-Fi IC are integrated with the CPU in most phones. But I'm going to show you this one. This one is not being integrated with the CPU. So I'm going to show you so that you will be able to identify it in any other phone. So just take a look at this PCB right here. You will see one section. Just look at this part right here. You will see one section which is similar to the network IC, which is similar to the network section. If you check this section right here, you will see that it's similar to the network section. And these are the package resistors. This one is not complicated. This one is not complicated to identify. These are the package resistors which are used in filtering signal in any network section. Wi-Fi Bluetooth is all about signals. It does not need a high amount of voltage to work. It just needs some amount of voltage to switch on the IC so that it can start sending a signal to the CPU and distributing signals whenever you control the phone. So if you check any phone, you open any phone, you notice two network sections. If you open any phone, I'll notice two network sections. Like this phone, we have this network section right here. Then we have this one, which is similar to network section two. Just know that the other section is for Wi-Fi and the other one is for network. The one for network is very easy because you will always see the network connector, antenna connector right here. And from the network antenna connector to the signal amplifier. Some phones does not have a 2G RF IC separately. Some phones combine 2G, 3G and 4G in the main network IC. So if you see a phone and you see only two ICs in the network section, that means the main network IC combines the two 3G and 4G, then send it to the signal amplifier before you distribute it to the antenna right here. And another way of easily identify Bluetooth IC and Wi-Fi IC is that you will mostly see that it has this type of pins. It's not a revolving chip, you understand what I'm saying, right? It always has this type of pins, the network and the Bluetooth IC. So let's take a look at a different IC right now. This IC right here is a charging IC. You might be asking yourself, how did I identify that this is a charging IC? It's very easy. Just take a close look. When you check here, you will see that here is a power capacitor. When you look at the size, you will know that this capacitor is dealing with some kind of amount of voltage. It's not a little voltage, you know what I'm saying? And when you check here, you will see that this is a power coil. And the most important place is that when you check the track that is leading to the coil, you will see that the track is bigger. I don't know if you know how to follow tracks, but if you don't know, then I have a video in this video description that will show you how to follow track. And there is another easy way to know. This is the best way to know if an IC is dealing with a high amount of voltage or not. When you look at this capacitor here, you will just notice that this is a power capacitor. It does not deal with voltage like 1 volt. And if you check here, you will see that this is a power coil. And when you take a close look right here and you see the line that is connected to this coil, you will see that the track is bigger. It's not smaller. So any track that you see in a mobile PCB that is bigger than the other, you just have to know that this track is dealing with a high amount of voltage, not like the normal voltage that most lines have, like 1 point something volt. So if you check here, you will see that this line here is bigger, which means it's the line that is bringing the 5 volt from the charging port then to the IC. That is why the line is this big. And if you check, most phones charging IC have this type of ICs. It's not a revolving chip, you understand? It's not a revolving chip. So when you check, you'll see that it has this type of pins. And the best way to check a charging IC is that when you connect, for example, let me just give an example of on this PCB right here. This PCB right here, I already know that this V bus right here is the 5 volt that is coming in from the charging port. So if I want to know the charging IC of this motherboard right now, I'm going to set my multimeter to boost mode. I don't have a multimeter right now, but I think I will explain in a way that you will understand. You just have to set your multimeter right here to boost mode, put one probe right here, then check, keep testing and see the IC that is connected to. So for this PCB right here, this is the charging IC. I think if you just look from my explanation from this board, you will know that this is the charging IC here. We have the boost coil of the charging IC here. We have the power diode and we have the charging filtered resistor, which acts like a fuse right here. So if you check this point here in boost mode, if you check test this point here in boost mode, you will see that it's connected to one of these diodes, and from there you will know that this is the charging IC. And charging ICs are different. Let me give you an example of how ICs work, of how charging ICs work and how different they are. Okay, good. Take a look at this motherboard right here. This is the charging IC of this motherboard, but the charging signal of this motherboard is not from the charging signal that is always showing that your phone is being connected. It's not from this IC, but it's from the CPU. This IC right here just regulates and filter the voltage that will charge the battery properly. Then it sends signal from the CPU to indicate that this charger is okay and this phone is charging. So the difference with this IC and this one right here is that this one gets its signal from this IC right here. This phone gets its signal from this IC. Meanwhile, the other one gets the charging signal from the CPU. So the IC that we will be looking on how to identify right now will be the sound IC. I will show you the sound IC on this PCB, then I will show you how I get to know that it's the sound IC. This IC right here is the sound IC. Yeah, it's the sound IC. And here, the sound crystal right here amplifies the sound that is from the sound IC and send it back to the sound IC so that you will get it in this filtered resistor. Then from here to the speaker. I hope you understand what I'm saying. You just get a little signal of sound in the sound IC and it send it to this crystal right here. The crystal amplifies it, then send it back to the sound IC here. Then these resistors take it and send it directly to the speaker. So for you to easily identify the sound IC, you will always have these two filtered resistors. They are just like a thermistor. Let me bring it closer so that you will see these two ICs right here. You will always see these two resistors right here. You will always see them around any sound IC. So let me show you in a different PCB. So I have put this PCB right here. I think you can already show me. You can show me the sound IC here already. You can identify the sound IC on this PCB already. Here is the sound IC. And if you check here, you will see the two resistors that I'm talking about. Not all sound ICs has a sound crystal, you know what I'm saying? So this is the two resistors that I'm talking about here, and they are the resistors that are connecting the sound and filtering the sound to the speaker, you know what I'm saying? So the sound IC is quite easy to identify, and what I want you to understand is that most sound ICs on most phones are generated from the CPU. Some phones does not have a sound IC, you know what I'm saying? Some phones does not have a sound IC. Some phones sound are generated from the CPU. So if you are having sound problem on some phones, you won't see any sound IC to change. The problem might be coming from the CPU. If there is no sound and you see no sound IC. So I make sure you are clear with that. So let's move to the next IC. So the IC that I will be showing you how you can identify right now will be the backlight IC. the backlight controller IC, the IC that lights up your screen, the IC that lights up the light that is always shining in your screen, that adjusts the brightness that you always see in your screen. So the IC, I'm not going to show you on this PCB, because the IC, the backlight IC on this PCB is quite different from how it is in most devices. So I will show you both on this PC so that you will understand and you won't get confused. On this PCB, this is the sound. This is the backlight IC. On this PCB, this is the backlight IC, and this is the boost coil, and this is the boost coil, and this is the backlight diode. So on this PC right here, this is the backlight section. This little section here. And it's very easy to identify, because when you see a backlight section, you will always see the backlight controller, which in most cases it's a 6-pin IC. Then you will see the boost coil and you will see the diode. Let me show you in this other PCB right here. If you check this PCB, I think you already know the backlight section. Here is the backlight section right here. This is the backlight controller IC, this is the boost coil, and this is the diode, the backlight diode right here. And if I show you in another device right here, you will see that it's still the same thing. If I show you on this PCB right here, you will see that it's still the same thing. You have the backlight controller, you have the backlight diode, and the boost coil. So it's very easy to identify backlight section or backlight IC. So for in this device, it's kind of complicated. Here is the backlight IC and the graphic controller of this PCB. So if I want to talk about this, it will really be complicated, because they are different. This type of backlight IC are different in most phones. You understand what I'm saying, right? Are different in most phones. But this type is the most common one that are in most phones. So that is why I showed you how you can identify this one. You will always see the backlight controller, see the boost coil, and the diode in all phones, all PCB that has this type of backlight controller. So now let's look on how to identify a power IC. I think this is the most simplest one, because I have talked about this in many videos. So if you haven't watched any of the videos, then I will just go on and show you how to identify a power IC. So right here on this PCB right now, this is the power controller IC on this PCB, and it's the main component that distributes voltages to different ICs on the phone. So how can you identify a power IC? A power IC is the main IC that deals with low, high amount of voltage. So when you check around it, you will see that it has so many coils, so many capacitors, and so many filtered coils. You know what I'm saying? So let me just step on this other PCB right here. I think you can already show me. You can show me the power IC here on this PCB. It has so many coils around it, so many big capacitors, and it has a power crystal. And if I show you the other PCB right now, this is an Intel PCB, and Intel PCB does not mount much components on the PCB. So it only has a CPU, has a eMMC, and it has the power IC, then the network IC. Most of the time it does not even have a network IC. It has but a signal amplifier, because most Intel network are coming from the CPU. The network IC are being mounted from the CPU. So here on this Intel motherboard, this is the power IC. You can see some big capacitors around it, and it's just few components on this PCB. And if I put this other PCB here, you will just show me the power IC. Here is the power IC. You see the boost coil, see the filtered coils, you see the power capacitors. So the power IC is very easy to identify, because you will always see high components, high voltage components, like bigger components around the power IC, and they will be much more than they are in any other part on the phone, because the power IC deals with a lot of different voltages and a lot of high voltages. You know, understand what I'm saying, right? So right now, let's go to the next IC. I will show you the flashlight IC, and I will show you how to identify any flashlight IC on any PCB. So what you need to know is that the flashlight The flashlight IC is very similar to the backlight IC on any PCB. For example, on this PCB, this is the flashlight IC. What I mean by flashlight IC is the IC that controls the voltage that lights up the flash, like when you're on your torch in your phone, when you are trying to snap and the flash flashes. This is the IC that controls the flash on this PCB. And if you look at the IC, you'll see that it's quite similar to the backlight IC on these other PCBs. On this PCB right now, the IC that lights up this flash here, that lights up this light here, is this one. This is the flashlight IC on this PCB. And if you look very well, you will see that it's similar to this charging IC right here. So the flashlight IC is always similar to a charging IC or similar to a backlight IC. You understand? So when I put this other PCB right here, the flash IC which controls this light right here, this is the flash IC. You will see that this is the charging IC, this is the backlight IC, and this is the flash IC. It too has bigger capacitors because it deals with some kind of amount of voltage. It does not deal with low amount of voltage, so it needs to have some kind of bigger filtered capacitors around it. And it always similar to the charging IC or to the backlight IC. So I hope you do understand that very well. So if I keep this PCB right here and you look at it, I think you will know the backlight, the flash IC right here. And one thing you need to know, that the flash IC is always around the flashlight. So if I ask you to show me that thing on this PCB right here, I think you already know it. This is the backlight. This is the flash IC. Sorry, this IC right here is the flash IC. If you look very well, it's very similar to the backlight IC right here. So this IC right here controls the light that is always shining here, controls the voltage that lights up this light. So I hope you do understand that. So let's talk about CPU and eMMC. The CPU and eMMC are the easiest things to identify on a PCB. Very easy. Obviously, they are the largest ICs on any PCB, on any mobile PCB. And let me just tell you the best way so that you can be able to identify them very easily. When you hold your motherboard right in front of you and you are like confused because some phones the CPU is bigger than the eMMC and some phones the eMMC is bigger than the CPU. When you are like confused that which one is the CPU, like some Qualcomm phones, you will see a Qualcomm CPU, then you will still see a Qualcomm power IC. So when you are confused about that, which one is the CPU and which one is the RAM, then you just go online, then type in your phone model, then type the CPU type, ask the CPU type. They will just show you the CPU type that this phone is using. If it's a MediaTek, they will show you that it's a MediaTek. If it's a Qualcomm CPU, they will show you. So that from now, when you know that this CPU type of this phone is MediaTek, when you just open it, you will see that this IC right here is a MediaTek. So when you know that this IC right here is a MediaTek, then you will know that this one is the eMMC. You see, very easy to identify. It's very easy. Some of these things are not really complicated. You just need to identify them over and over in different PCBs. So I'm just giving you this idea right now so that you will have experience and you will try to experience more by yourself. Because different phones come with different IC form. Just give this video a thumbs up by liking, and if you haven't subscribed to my channel, just do that right now because I'm going to upload more tutorial videos and more videos. So make sure you stay tuned to my channel because you can learn a lot from this channel.